It is Thursday, April 6th, 2017. I'm Dan Rubin. This is the Bucknuts Morning Five and Change. Coming to you live on tape from the Midwest, Gem City in particular. You know it's Gray. Talking to my man, Steve Wiltfong, Director of Recruiting for 24/7 Sports. Steve, how's the daycare run going today?
Man, raining here in the suburbs of Indianapolis. No smoothie. My wife is out of town. I'm hurting, Daniel. I'm hurting. No nutrient yet today for me.
My wife is also out of town, out of the country with half my family, so I am solo parenting and doing a mediocre job at best, but I digress. People you can rely on to do a great job all the time, Ohio State staff on the recruiting trail. A name has bubbled up. Very hard on Bucknuts to pick out a name most people haven't heard of. You've managed to do that. Jake Cradle, offensive lineman out of Pennsylvania, was offered, and then crystal ball of yours flipped. Bring us stem to stern on Jake Cradle.
Well, the only reason why I bring you a name that you're not that familiar with is because he wasn't, you know, Ohio State offered him yesterday. He tagged me in his tweet that Ohio State offered. I asked him a couple follow-up questions. He says the Buckeyes are the team to beat right now. It's in his upcoming rotation of visits. I expect that to go well, and then we'll see what happens from there. But there's no question right now Ohio State leads for the hard-nosed offensive lineman from Pennsylvania.
What do you say to the people who look at his ranking and think, this guy is not Ohio State caliber?
Well, no ranking. Well, first of all, you know, obviously Coach Studd and Coach Meyer and Coach Kevin Wilson and those guys think he's pretty good. He's got like 20 offers, so, you know, there's a lot of college coaches that think he's good, and they can't all be 4 and 5 stars, and maybe this is one that we're low on right now, and, you know, we'll see Jake. I may even see Jake Sunday in Cleveland at the Nike camp, so that'll be another opportunity to look at him, and no ranking is final till signing day, so people are going to move accordingly until then. So, you know, right now, if I'm a Bucknuts reader, you know, I say, hey, Ohio State's offered this guy, and you're in the lead. And, you know, Ohio State's also led for a lot of guys that they haven't signed before. And it isn't because, you know, they got beat out for the young man. So we'll see what transpires for Mr. Cradle. But all I can say right now is that that offer was a very exciting one for him and that he told me Ohio State leads.
No doubt, and it's not like his offer list was paltry. You've got some other good teams on there, Maryland, NC State, Pittsburgh, Rutgers, but it does seem like an Ohio State offer could open up Mr. Cradle's future in terms of ranking and quality.
Right,
of offer.
Alabama offered a receiver from Louisville this morning. You know, that's one of the first big offers he's gotten, so sometimes you got to be the first big fish to jump in the pool.
I'll bet the Cradle will rock right its way to Columbus. That's just me. I want to talk about other guys you have crystal balls. One recently, and then I kind of want to do an inventory just to kind of bring up to speed here. The one you recently flipped last week, Houston Griffith, defensive back. Talk about why you did that and how you expect that to play out.
Well, for the longest, I thought it's Notre Dame or Ohio State, and talking to, you know, Houston and the family at the Chicago Nike event, I got the sense that Ohio State is the team to beat right now. And you know, we'll see how the Buckeyes continue to recruit Houston. And I think the ball's kind of in Ohio State's court right now. Notre Dame is a legit threat, but I think that Ohio State's the team to beat right now.
All right, I'm going to go rapid fire here, and you give me your vibe on these crystal ball picks you have logged in for Ohio State currently. So every name I read off here, people, is a name Steve Wiltfong has flipped to Ohio State crystal ball-wise. Keep in mind, some of these were made going back to Cameron Babb, November 17th of last year. So we're going to make sure Steve's minding his P's and Q's here. Here I go. In reverse chronological in reverse chronological order. Michael Harris.
Ohio State. I still feel good about that. If Ohio State pushes for him, they'll get him. He's visiting in this month.
Matthew Jones.
I think Ohio State's a team to beat for Matthew Jones still. Haven't heard any different.
Tavion Thomas.
I think that if Tavion Thomas takes care of everything he needs to take care of, he'll be a Buckeye.
Tyreek Smith.
I think Tyreek Smith will be ultimately be a Buckeye. You know, he's taking a lot of visits and heading a lot of places. But, you know, I think if Ohio State puts the full court press on him, they'll get him.
Virtus Brown.
So I like the Buckeyes there, but he's kind of in the same, you know. I think Ohio State's a team to beat, but there's a lot of people, there's a lot of prospects in this 2018 cycle that have stuff that they have to take care of to play at universities they want to play at.
We understand code. Jeremy Rucker.
I still like Ohio State. There's no doubt that Michigan's in there. Among others, but I like Ohio State.
Cameron Babb.
I still like Ohio State. Michigan made a hell of a run this past weekend, and you know, we'll see what happens this spring and summer, but the Buckeyes have been the team to beat for the longest, and others are playing catch-up, and Michigan took their swing over the weekend and did a nice job.
Okay, those are the ones you have crystal balled. We're going to finish off with questions about two guys, linebackers, and Ohio. Just your first, Christopher Oates.
Well, I think that Christopher Oates is a situation where Ohio State will know what Dallas Gant has done before Chris Oates is ready to decide. So I think that Dallas Gant is the guy that will dictate the future for a lot of people at a lot of schools.
Which brings me to my last name, Dallas Gant.
I don't know. Could see him at a couple places, and my gut was Notre Dame when we talked about it last week, and I think Notre Dame's got some built-in advantages for Dallas with him going to the type of school that he goes to. That's a school that's typically attractive to a Notre Dame type of kid, but obviously Ohio State's recruiting the hell out of him. I think that, I mean, I still can't erase the memory of Dallas Gant walking into Friday Night Lights last summer and the entire family decked out in Ohio State gear. And you know Ohio State's recruiting them well. And you wonder if Coach Fickell taking a head coach job at UC opened the door. I'm not sure. There was a time where Ohio State definitely led for Dallas Gant. Notre Dame hired a new D coordinator and a new linebackers coach. The new D coordinator at Notre Dame is a lot more engaging on the recruiting trail than the old one, and he's got a great track record. So I don't know. I really don't know. And Dallas Gant's face lit up when he talked about Penn State, called Michigan State his dream school. And I know that, you know, most times it's easy to sift through when a recruit says stuff like that. But for Dallas, it comes across as pretty damn genuine.
Add in the fact that he's in Toledo, and it makes it even more confusing. We appreciate Steve stopping by. That was a meat-laden, dense, named, information-packed BM5. We hope you enjoyed it. Have a good one, Bucknutters.
Appreciate it, guys.